how can we recognize the inner child within us? The simplest way is to listen what other people are saying. There are specific words that can signal you that the person is using the defensive mechanism. The person is using filters. And those words are, it's not fair. This is unfair. People who say this is unfair, it's their inner child words. An adult understands that life is not always fair. Fear is not even the right word to use in adulthood. If something happens to you, if something happens not as you planned it, an adult can evaluate the situation, evaluate the reasons why this happened to him, and can make a conclusion how to do it better next time. But when the person is saying it's not fair, this is unfair, and not going into any evaluation, just complaints, this is not an adult is talking. This is the inner child words. Another phrase is like, why me? Why me? Why this happened to me? And again, an adult, he will either know why this happened to him, or an adult will not ask this question. Sometimes, I would say even often, this question does not have an answer. Sometimes you don't know why, it's just happened. And if you don't know why, you just move on. But if you think and you find the reason, then you're not gonna complain about life, you're not gonna complain about fate, you will find the way how to do it better next time. And instead of complaining, why not, why me, you're going to focus on what can you do to change the situation. And if the person is not focusing on the results, if the person is not focusing how to do it better, then the person is going to complain about life. Complain about other people, complain about the government, about the laws, about the taxation. And why me is not a phrase for an adult. This is the inner child phrase. The next one, you have to. The inner child always expects something. Everyone has to do something for him. Especially he expects a lot of things from the partner, from the friends, from family members. For example, a woman who expects that her man will make her laugh and make her happy, right? You're my husband, you have to make me happy. Kids sometimes can say like, oh, you're my parent, you should make me happy. You should do what I ask. You're my parent. Kids expecting from parents to satisfy their needs, to satisfy their desires. And when you hear this phrase from an adult, it means that his or her inner child is in pain, and the inner child is asking you to do something. A mother who expects her children to call her adult children to call her at least 3 times a day, like, I'm your mother, you don't call me. A good son should call his mother like 2-3 times a week. You never call, you never ask how's my life. Again, this is not like an adult mother, this is the inner child's mother. A woman, a mother who expects her daughter to share all her secrets with her. And if she does not share it with her, then mother gets very sad and she might say, I'm not gonna talk to you anymore. You are the bad daughter, this is not the way how I raised you. And she becomes a manipulator. And she will try to get this extra attention from her daughter. And the phrase is, you have to. The next phrase is like, I don't have to. You have to, but I don't. And the inner child expects that other people will do something for him, but he's not gonna do anything in return. For example, a woman who does not want to play with her kids or spend time with them, she can say, mommy's tired, mommy's busy, Mommy does not feel good, but you should love your mommy. You should understand that your mommy is tired. You should be nice to your mother. You should behave well. So she is expecting from children a lot of things, but in return, she is not giving them enough love, enough attention. And these children will grow up and they will not be able to mature. They will not be able to create happy, healthy relationship because they did not get enough love. So do you see how this mechanism is going through generations, from mother to children, from children to their children? Another example, a father who leaves his family and believes that his kids will be better without him. My parents divorced when I was 11. And when my father moved to another city, he did not call me, he did not visit me, he did not send any gifts, anything for my birthday. I did not, he just disappeared. When I was 16, I've met my father and I asked him, I said, like, why you never called, not even on my birthday? And he told me this. He said, I thought this is better for you. I thought that if I'm gonna visit you, it's gonna be more painful. So I decided that when you grow up, you will understand it. Again, you have to understand me, but I don't have to do anything for you, right? So the father basically is saying, you are my child and you have to understand me. I could not create a relationship with your mother. Our marriage was falling apart. So I decided to move to another city. You have to understand me, but I'm not gonna do anything for you. This is the inner child. This is a selfish mechanism of the inner child. Another example, a father who visits kids twice a month instead of raising them. So instead of paying attention, spending time with your kids, instead of raising your kids, a father becomes like a weekend father. So I'm a good one. I'm gonna take kids to the movie. I'm gonna have fun with them. I'm gonna play with them. And the mother is gonna be the bad one because she's gonna raise them. She's gonna teach them. She's gonna say no to them. And I'm gonna be a vocational father. I'm the good one. You should love me the way I am. I'm not gonna teach you. I'm not gonna spend time with you only for fun stuff. Another example, a grandmother or grandfather who spoiled grandkids and breaks the rules that parents create. A grandmother can say something like, oh, I don't have to teach your kids. I don't have to raise your kids. You should do it. And she's right. Parents should teach their kids. Parents should be responsible for the kids, for their kids, right? But at the same time, grandmother does not have the right to break the rules, because when she is breaking the rules that mother and father created, the kids is not gonna follow those rules and it's gonna be in conflict. So the grandmother who is saying, I wanna be a good one, I don't have to do anything, I don't have to follow your rules, I don't have to teach kids, I'm gonna spoil kids. They have to love me. And in order for them to love me, I have to spoil them. Another phrase of the inner child is why. Why this is happening to me? Why me? I don't understand why. I think we already spoke about why. Yes, why me? It was the second. Okay, so next one, moving on. When we use baby names, when a woman calls her husband Bunny, Babe, my sweetheart, and it sounds so cute, it sounds so nice, and when you hear those words, you think, oh my God, they have such a gentle feelings towards each other. And then this woman comes to the therapy, and she's asking, why my Bunny cannot make money? Or why my sweetheart has to stay late at work and help others? Because he's a sweetheart. He cannot say no. He has to stay at work late. And your Bunny is not making money because he's a Bunny. A little child cannot make money. Or she's saying, oh, my Babe cannot ask for promotion at work because he's your Babe. He's a baby. Baby cannot compete in an adult world. Baby cannot ask for promotion. So when you call your husband, baby, bunny, sweetheart, honey, you're putting an anchor on him. He's not a man anymore. He's bunny. He's not a successful leader. He's your honey. And when you call your man those words day after day, again and again, he's getting used to this name, to this role. And I know all of you have a question, so how should you call your man? He has a name. Call your bunny, honey, sweetheart by his name. Do not diminish your partner.